We have two integrals on the spot. The first one, the integral of 1 over x squared minus 5x plus 6. And the second one, the integral of 2x minus 5 over x squared minus 5x plus 6. As you can see, these two, they both have the same denominator. However, over there, the type is just 1. But for this one, we have the 2x minus 5. Which one do you think is easier than the other? Pause the video and do the easy one first. Okay, so as you can see, they are just rational functions, right? So to integrate them, the typical way is we factor the denominator and then we do partial fractions. However, in that case, yes, we have to do partial fraction because this one on the top is not that useful. On the other hand, when we have the 2x minus 5, this is much more preferable because why? This 2x minus 5 happens to be exactly the derivative of the denominator. The derivative of x squared is the 2x, and the derivative of minus 5x is the minus 5. The derivative of plus 6 is 0, so it doesn't matter. So you see, we can just do this by u substitution. So let's finish this within like 40 seconds or so. So let's go ahead and do it. Then u is equal to x squared minus 5x plus 6, and then let's do du, which is, you know, 2x minus 5 dx, and then we can divide both sides by that. So we get dx is equal to du over 2x minus 5. And then we can take this into the u world. On the top is the 2x minus 5 over the denominator is u. And then dx is that. So we have the du over 2x minus 5. This and that cancel. And we are just integrating 1 over u in the u world. So we get ln absolute value of u. At the end, u is that. So we plug in. So this is going to be ln absolute value of x squared minus 5x plus 6. And then we are done. So we put plus c. And this is it. Okay? I'm not sure if it was 40 seconds or not, but then that shouldn't be too bad. This is actually my main dish. That was just the appetizer. Okay? And that was one of the questions I put on my final exam for my calculus 2 students. Anyways, let me show you how we can do partial fractions right here with an easier way. As we can see on the denominator, we have x squared minus 5x plus 6, right? We have the first factored out. And to factor that out, we get x minus 3 times x minus 2. And you notice that both of them are linear factors, and these two factors are different. In this case, good things happen, okay? Because this is going to be the nice and easy and fun case. And I'll show you how we can set up the partial fraction right here, and you should do so as well when you're doing this on your own. So the idea of doing partial fraction is we will break down this big fraction into two smaller fractions, right? And then let me just put down the integral sign. And then the first small fraction will have this as the denominator, but then I don't know what's going to be on the top. It has to be a number, just a number, because we only have a linear factor on the denominator, okay? And then we are going to combine with the second little fraction, which will have this on the denominator, but then we don't know what number will go on the top. So let's leave this two blank. And this is how we are going to figure out these numbers right here. Well, let's figure out the first one first. This number is above x minus 3, right? So what we have to do is refer back to the original fraction and then cover up the same denominator. Here we have the x minus 3, so we are going to cover this up with your hand, or maybe when you're doing this on your paper, you use your finger. But then I'm going to cover this up with my hand. And then you have to ask yourself, how can you make your hand zero? How can you make this factor equal to zero? This is x minus 3. How can you make x minus 3 equal to zero? Well, x has to be 3, right? So when you cover this up, you have to make x is equal to 3. And what I mean is, this is gone now, but then you have to plug in x is equal to 3 into the remaining x. Well, on the top, we just have 1. We have to plug in 3 into this x. So let's do this in our head. On the top, we have 1 over 3 minus 2, which is 1 on the bottom. 1 over 1 is what? It's 1. So then this number right here is 1. And you can check out my other videos. I've done a lot of other examples on how we can do the calc method for the partial fractions. Okay? And let's do another one right here. To figure out this number, you see this is x minus 2. So we refer back to the original fraction, and we cover up the same denominator, which is my hand right here. But then how can we make my hand 0? Well, x has to be 2, right? Well, this is out already. You got rid of this already. You cover this up. Plugging 2 into this x here. And we see we have 1 on the top over 2 minus 2, which is negative 1 on the bottom. 1 over negative 1, we get negative 1 right here. And that's it. That's the cover-up method for the partial fraction. And it only works nicely when you have the factors on the bottom to be linear and they are different. Anyways, I will make sure I'll do more videos. If this requests, I'll do more videos for you guys for the cover-up method for partial fractions. Well, we can totally integrate this now and then integrate that, right? So let me just write down my equal sign here. And here we go. The integral of 1 over x minus 3 is ln absolute value x minus 3. And this is it, because the derivative of x minus 3 is 1. So we don't need to divide anything, you know, we don't need to do anything fancy. And then we are going to integrate this right here, and let's put down the minus right here first, okay? This minus goes right here. And then we just integrate 1 over x minus 2. So we have ln absolute value and then just x minus 2, because the derivative of this is just 1. So once again, nothing fancy. And this is technically it. But since we have two ln's and then in between we have a subtraction, so we can put them together with a division. So this right here, we can write this down as ln absolute value, and then we can put the x minus 3 on the top and then over that x minus 2 on the bottom, absolute value, and then we are done. Put a plus c, and that will complete this integration. Cool, huh?
That's it.